Hey everybody, and welcome back to Instant Gameplay. My name is Sean, and today we are doing a playthrough. It was pretty much a unanimous vote with everybody that voted with our last public vote for which game they wanted to see. So thank you for everybody who voted. The game that won, surprisingly, I didn't think this game was going to win, but it was pretty much a unanimous vote, and that is Viticulture. So we are going to be starting our playthroughs. We're going to be doing a solo playthrough of Viticulture, but obviously you're not going to be able to see the board very clearly from there. So let's get you above the table so you can see exactly what's going on. All right, so we are all set to start our playthrough of Viticulture. We pretty much have the board set up. There's a couple things I just wanted to go over with you so you could see. Now, this isn't going to be a full rules explanation, but I do want to give you an idea of how the game is played. So basically, what we are going to be doing is we are going to be going through 7 rounds here of gameplay. This little rooster token is my first player token. Now, I chose white because it sticks out really well on the board, and then purple is gonna be the Automa player. So when you see those on the board, that's not me, that's the, think of it as like the computer player, or my opponent. Down here we've got all the different buildings and everything that we're going on here. We start the game off with one Pinot card. I might be butchering some of these wine names, I do apologize for that. Here's the Automa deck, we'll be drawing cards from that to be putting the purple workers out on the board, and that'll tell us where we can't go. But first we have to figure out our starting stuff, and the way we do that in this particular version of Viticulture is with the Mama and the Papa card. So we look at both of these cards and they tell us what our starting stuff is for the game. So first we'll look at this card. We have Papa J, and he will give us our Grande meeple. Focus. Not gonna focus right there, but that's okay. It gives us our Grande meeple. It gives us, so we're gonna have our big guy right here. He's gonna go in our available worker spot. He's also going to give us 5 coins to start with. And the way I like to use my starting game, because we have these big guys here that are 5, but really in the beginning stages, you won't be spending that much. So I do, you know, 3 ones, and then a 2. So just we have some stuff to work with there. And then we also get our choice of either putting out our yoke, which is this little guy right here, or we can have 2 more coins. And I think, or in this game it's Lira, I think what I want to do is I'm going to put the yoke out because it gives us an extra location we can go to that can't be blocked by the Automa player. So I think that's going to be really good. It would normally cost us $2, but you know, to get that right away in the beginning of the game I think is a really good idea. So we're going to do that. Now let's take a look at the Mama card. We have Mama Danielle, and she gives us 2 meeples to start with. So we're going to have a total of 3 meeples to start, but we can always get more. And we're going to start with 2 yellow cards and 1 blue card. So what we're going to do for that is these yellow cards are summer visitor cards. These are people that are coming to our vineyard in the summer months, which is this half of the board. And then the blue is going to be the winter visitor cards. So we're going to get 2 yellow ones. And this tells us what we can do on a turn when we play these cards. So this one is the Stonemason. This one says pay $8 to build any 2 structures and ignore their regular costs. And this one is the Sharecropper. Plant 1 green card even without the required structures, or uproot and discard 1 green card to gain 2 victory points. And that's going to be big because right here on the bottom of the board is the victory track. We need to exceed 20 points, which is where the purple player's at. So we have to get to 20 points. It's not easy to do in a solo mode, so we are going to do try to get to there. So to get 2 points pretty much for just kind of doing nothing or very little is very good. So we're going to keep these to the side here. I'm just going to put them down here. They might be a little out of view from the camera, but when I want to use them, I will let you know. So next thing is we also got 1 blue visitor card, and this one is the Zymologist. I'm not really big into wine, so I drink it and that's about it. But make up to 2 glasses of wine or of value 4 or greater, even if you haven't upgraded your cellar. That's awesome. That's going to be really good. It's going to save us some time in upgrading our cellars. So I'm just going to place that down here. Now we can only have I believe it's 7 cards. Yep, we can only have 7 cards down here at any given time. So this will change. These cards might, we might have to get more and get, you know, work for less and that kind of stuff. And that's going to be one part of the game that we're really going to have to work with. So we're going to get started with the game. If you know how to play Viticulture already, you'll notice that normally when you start the game in a round, you're going to pick your location for waking up with the other players. This is going to be our round marker. I can take any of these rounds and get the required thing that I want. So I can go here and get nothing. I can take a green card, a purple card, a coin, a yellow or a blue card, a victory point, or an extra worker for the round. But when I do, I can't go back there in a future round. So if I were gonna go here, I would then take this glass token and put it in my supply, and that will allow me to take a bonus action during this actual gameplay of the worker placement part. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna decide what we wanna do. Now, I obviously don't wanna go here because that is the first round. I wanna do something right away. And what I like to do first and foremost is I think I'm gonna take the victory point right away. And the reason I'm going to do that, so I'm going to take the glass token off the board. It's going to go into my supply. I'll just put it up here. And the reason I'm going to do that is because I don't know what the Ottoma player is going to do yet. I haven't, there's really no way of knowing. So I'm going to take that victory point just as a precaution. I've got one on the board, and then in the future turns, based on what we have down here with cards, I can choose other cards and other locations rather, and that'll tell me where I need to go. So now we've chosen our wake up positions. Now it's the summer location or the summer worker placement, which is the yellow spaces. We have to draw from this Ottoma deck. Now I'm not playing with the Tuscany expansion, so any Tuscany part on here we can ignore. But this is going to tell us where we have to put our purple meeples. So we are going to go ahead and look at this one. This is we are only looking at the green and yellow parts because we are in summer. So it wouldn't be purple or blue, or in this case, red or blue. We are looking at this. So it says build one structure. Those correspond to these guys down here. So we're gonna take this and we're gonna place it right there. We cannot go there. So the other one is the T for Tuscany. We can ignore that, and those we can ignore. So that was the Ottoma player's turn. So we just cannot build a structure, which is kind of unfortunate, but that's okay. It's early in the game and we might not want to build a structure quite yet, so we'll see. So now I get to decide where I want to go. Now I have three guys to work with here, and the trick is I can place them anywhere that I want on here except for this location here. I'm gonna turn this guy so you can see it. However, if I place them all on the yellow, when it comes to the blue part, I won't be able to place any there. So I think what I want to do to start is I'm going to plant, because that's a big thing, and I have this Pinot card, I need to plant it, so it's gonna get planted here, except I can't plant it. And the reason I can't plant it is because there's a trellis right there. So this build, so that I can't do. However, what I can do is potentially, I think I'm going to go here, play a yellow card, because we have the sharecropper, which plant one green card even without the required structures, and that's what we're gonna do. So we are going to get rid of this card, and we are gonna plant our Pinot. And that's gonna go there. So now what we're gonna do is we have to decide, do we wanna keep going or do we wanna save it for winter? And I think I need to plant at least one more, or I need to do one more thing, maybe. Yeah, I think what I want to do, actually, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going, yeah, I'm actually going to take a guy and I'm going to use, because we have our yoke, I'm going to go over here, and that's going to allow me to uproot one vine or harvest one field. So I'm going to harvest this field. Now this stays here. Some people play where you actually take it out. I'm going to keep it there. So what then we're going to do is we're going to take two of our little glass tokens and we're going to place them on down here in our crush pad where they correspond. So we're going to have a one level grape there, and a red grape, and a one level white grape right there. These will age at the end of the round, and right now this is both worth 1 coin if we were to sell. So now we have to decide what we want to do. Do I want to give up winter? I don't think I do. I do not want to give up winter. So now we're going to draw a visitor card because it is now fall. So I can draw either a yellow or a blue. We got rid of the yellow one, so I think I'm going to draw another yellow one. And that's going to be the wine critic. Draw two blue cards or discard one wine of value 7 or more to gain 4 points. That's going to be very handy. Now we have to draw another Ottoma card because we are in worker placement phase. So we are going to go like this. We are only looking at red and blue, and it's going to be these two right here. So the first one is going to be harvest one field. So we are going to put a guy on harvest one field, which is actually very good that we went over here because we wouldn't be able to do that. So I thought ahead and I'm very happy I did that. And make up to 2 wine tokens. Now that's kind of a bummer because I wanted to make some wine. So we'll place another guy there. So that's kind of a bummer, but not the biggest deal in the world. So the next thing we have to do is figure out where does this guy want to go. And actually I've been placing the wrong guys out this whole time because they should be these guys here. So I'm going to move my workers that I should. So we're going to move 2 over here because I have 2 on the board. These are going to be our supply of ones that we can train. That's my fault. I normally keep them underneath just for my, but it says available workers. I wanted to show you that. So we have our Grande worker. The Grande worker is very cool because he can actually go to a place that is already blocked, or he can go there and take the bonus action that is there. So if he were to go to draw a purple card, he can draw an extra purple card. He can go here because he's the Grande worker and harvest the field or make up to 2 wine tokens. I think what we want to do is I'm going to just go here right away and I'm going to pay 4 lira. And that is to train, which means I'm gonna get an additional worker that I can use on my next turn. Now, if I pay an additional worker, I can get another one, and you bet I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna use all my money to get an additional worker. So I now have 5 workers, which is awesome. And I love that. That's just so awesome. So that ends that particular part of the game. So now we're moving on to the year end phase. This part over here tells you exactly the order, which is really nice that that's on the board. So next we're going to age grapes and wine tokens. So down here, we're just going to move these up from a level 1 to a level 2. And then we are going to retrieve workers. Now we would age wine if we had any, we don't have any yet. So now we're going to retrieve all our workers. We have the one over here, and then we've got these 2 here. So those are all of our workers. So next thing we have to do is collect residual payment. That's down here. It's pointing to 1, so we will always get 1 coin. Now, some people play it, and I kind of house rule this, where it starts off as 0. I started at 1. And the reason I do that is because getting money can be kind of hard sometimes in this game, so if you always get at least 1 payment, but that can go up throughout the game. So you're always gonna get 1 to start, but hopefully that goes up as we, you know, continue with the game. First round. So now, we are gonna move on to the second round of play. So for the second round of play, we're gonna reset the rooster up to the top here, and I can pick any location here except number 6 because I already went there and got that bonus point. So now what I wanna do, I think, is I'm gonna go to number 3 here, which is a purple card, and I'm gonna take that bonus thing. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take these purple cards. Now these purple cards are contracts. So this particular one wants a level 4 white wine, a level 3 white wine, and a level 2 white wine. And then in return, once I complete this, I'll get 4 victory points and I'll get to up my residual payment to the next level. So that's really awesome. So now we have a starting point of where we need to actually go with our wines. So that means we need to start crushing some more wines and get more wines on the board because we need to get a lot of white wines. So that's what we're gonna try to do. We actually also have to remove these guys from the board. Forgot to do that. Now I know somebody's gonna ask where I got these little cups from. These are actually reusable cupcake liners. They're made out of like a silicone material. And we got them just from, I don't remember where, my wife got them, I don't remember where she got them from, but they're literally just reusable cupcake liners. They work really well for game components, so we didn't like how they worked when we were making actual things in the kitchen, so she gave them to me and I use them for game components. So it's really awesome. I'm sure you can go on Amazon and find them, just type in reusable or silicone cupcake liners, they're really awesome. Anyway, so now we're gonna move on. So we chose our wake up position, we took our bonus token there, and now we have to draw an Ottoma card, and that's yellow and green, so this is nothing, it's just Tuscany, we can ignore that, and we're not in winter, so we can ignore. So this Ottoma card, they're not gonna do anything this turn. That was super lucky. So now we can decide, we have a ton of workers to play with, so for sure I think the first thing we want to do is I want to go to the yolk one more time, and that's going to be harvesting, so I'm going to harvest. Now, these do not go away unless you sell them. So I'm going to place a token on age one. They always start as whatever they say, age one. That's going to be that, which is awesome. Next, I'm going to take another worker, and I think I'm going to draw a green card. And actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my Grande worker, so I can use the bonus action and draw two. So I'm going to draw my first one. It is another Pinot, and I'm going to draw this, and it is a Malvasia. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right. I'm sorry if I'm butchering that. That is just a level one. And Pinot we've already had, so that's really great. Now, if we wanted to plant this Pinot, we already used that one card that allowed us to build it without the structure. We would have to build that trellis. This one, however, doesn't require that, so that's really awesome. So now what we're gonna do is, I still got three workers left. What do I wanna do? Yeah, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold off and send all of these workers to winter because I really want to get some wine going. So hopefully I'll have that ability to do so. I think I probably should have saved this guy for that, because if we can't make wine, we're gonna be in trouble, but we'll get there. I'm not worried. So now what we're gonna do is we are gonna draw a visitor card, and I want to draw a blue one because we're going into winter. This one is the designer. Build one structure at its regular cost, then if you have at least six structures, gain 2 points. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if we gain any more cards, we're gonna have to discard. We also, remember, have the zymologist, and that's make up to 2 wines of value 4 or greater, even if you haven't upgraded your cellar. So we probably could take advantage of that. So that's gonna be really good. So now what we're gonna do is we are gonna draw an autumn card because it's winter. And this one is, we're only looking at the red and the blue. Harvest one field. Well, that actually worked out a little bit in our favor. I was gonna harvest, but I did that with my yolk, so I didn't have to worry about that. And then sell one wine token, but that's only for the Tuscany expansion, so this works out really, really well. So they only blocked one this whole round, so round two was very, very productive for us so far. Let's see where we go. We got three people to work with yet. So I'm gonna first and foremost make up to 2 wine tokens, and I'm going to save this card. And the reason is because this is available. I only want to use this if that's not available. So I'm going to make up to 2 wine tokens. So I'm going to make a level 2 white wine. So I just move it from level 2 grape to level 2, and I'm gonna make a level 2 red wine right away as well. So that's really good. We've already got this maintained here, level 2. Now we just have to get everything to age, and hopefully we'll be able to fulfill this by the next turn. Next, I want to, there's no point in paying to train yet because I still have 5. I don't have enough money to really play a card. I could draw another purple card, which I think I'm gonna do. I'm gonna draw another purple card, which means we'll have to discard, but that's okay. This is 1 level 5 white wine. We'll get 2 points, and we'll get to do the residual track will go up for payment. So that's really, really good. But now we have 8 cards. So we will have to draw down at the end, but that's okay. I know what I'm gonna get rid of already. So we're gonna take our final worker, and I'm just gonna go here. Anybody can go there. I can go there as many times as I want. This is just to gain 1. So I'm just going to gain a money here. And then what I'm going to do, probably should have used one of my bonus glass tokens, but that's okay. That's not a big deal. Okay, so that is the end of that. So now what we have to do is we have to age grape and wine tokens. So both of our grapes are gonna go up to level 2, and these are both gonna go up to level 3. Now here's the catch. We can't age these any further until we actually have a cellar, a medium cellar or a large cellar. Now we do have a card here that will allow us to do that, I think. Where did it go? Yep, this one, the zymologist, which we've looked at a couple times. So I can make 2 wine of a value 4 or greater, even if I don't, even if I haven't upgraded my cellar. So if I build a structure and upgrade the cellar, I can get in there and get in there and make better wines. However, now the medium cellar allows me to make blush wines, which is 1 sparkling, or one, not 1 sparkling, sparkling is meant 1 red and 1 white, that'll equal sparkling. So if I took both of these, 3 and 3, I could make 1 6-level blush wine. And then when we get to a large cellar, we've got sparklings, which is one white and two reds. So what I could do potentially is this would be one white and two red. This could work, but it would only be worth a level 7. Because it's gonna be values, and so I'd have to put that at 7, I think, if I did my math right. I might be wrong. Anyway, so let's move on to the next round here. So we're gonna get rid of all of our meeples here, and we have to draw down to 7 cards. Ooh, move our yoke back. So we retreat our workers. Let's get rid of this purple guy. Now we have to collect our residual payment. It's just 1. So we'll get 1 here, just want the 1. Now we've got some money to play with, so that's really good. And we have to discard down to 7 cards. I already have a Pinot here, so I'm just gonna discard this Pinot. I don't even have a trellis for it anyway, so it really doesn't pay for me to keep that, and I already have one in play. So now I have 7 cards, so we're good there. So next thing we have to do is rotate, but we don't do that because it's a solo mode. On to round 3, so I'm gonna move the rooster back up here so you can see all the options. Now we're getting into some interesting territory here. I think I want to go to number 4. That's going to give me a coin. And I'm going to go there because I need some money to be able to do things on the board now, because I spent it all training. Now I have to get more. So, and there's other ways to gain money. You can give a tour, which gives you 2, and then the bonus gives you a 3rd. But I haven't gone there yet, so that's kind of the thing we have to worry about, is how we're gonna get money. But we also get money by some of these cards, so they will give us some money. So we have to be careful what we do, and we gotta be observant of what we're doing. So now we did that. I'm going to take the Autumn card, and it says to give a tour. Speak of the devil, I just talked about that. Well, now we can't. Can't give a tour unless we use our Grande Meeple. Sell at least 1 grape or buy, sell 1 field. And we are going to have to block that as well. That's kind of annoying. And then the other 2 we ignore, so we'll just get rid of that. So now we have to figure out what we want to do for this round. I think what I want to do to start is, this is really, really tough. I'm going to draw a green card because I want to get something other than these lower wines. I want something better. And this one, it's another Malvasia. We're getting really low wines, and that's not good. We're in round 3. We only have 1 point. We need to get some points on the board. All right, let's see. So, you know what? I'm going to use one of these tokens to take another one because I can do that. This one is, it's another Pinot. Oh no, this is not good at all. There are other things in the deck, I promise. Okay, let's see. We need to, I'm gonna have to draw down to 7, so I might as well play some stuff this turn too. Let's go, you know what? Let's just plant something. Actually, we can build a structure now, can't we? We could build a structure, and I think that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go here, and we're gonna build a structure. We're gonna build this trellis. The trellis is gonna go right here. It's gonna cost us 2, and that is gonna allow us to make this other Pinot, and I wouldn't normally go for that this, I mean, I won't say late in the game, but that's normally a very early thing in the game you do, like round 1, round 2. However, that's all we're drawing, so we kinda have to do that. Now comes the dilemma. Do I plant because I can, or do I do something else? I think I'm gonna plant. I think I have to. So I'm gonna plant this other Pinot. I didn't wanna do that, but I feel like I have to. So that's a thing. Then what we're gonna do is I'm going to, you know, I might be making a bad choice here, but I'm gonna save my Grande and just put him in winter. And I'm gonna take this guy and put him here to harvest because I really need more wine. And we've really gotta get these contracts filled if we want points. So that's a big thing. So now I'm saving my Grande worker because I have these too. So I mean, I could potentially do a very big move in the winter phase. So let's take a look now at which card we wanna take. Now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, we have 8 cards. I have to draw a visitor card. I'm gonna draw a winter card. And this is the judge. Draw two yellow cards or discard one wine of value 4 or more to gain 3 points. So that's something there. Let's see. We have 9 cards. We're going to have to discard 2 cards at the end of this turn. Unless we draw more, which I don't think I'm going to do. But we have to do the automa here. So this one is, we don't do yellow. Red, draw a purple card. So he's going to go right here. And then fill, which is not good. That is not what we wanted. Because filling order here is how we get points. So that makes things a little more complicated. I can still go there because I have my Grande worker. But the question is, do I want to do that? I don't have enough of really anything to do that with. I could do the Zoomologist, which might not be a bad idea to go up there and get that in there. That might not be a bad idea. Well, I can't because I can only make 3. Ooh, that may have to wait till my next turn. This is what's so tough about this game is that as you play, you think, well, I can do this, and so I'm going to save it for this, but then, you know, the automa screws you up and you have to do something completely different. You know what I'm going to do? Because I'm just have to discard another card anyway. I'm going to take this guy because I can, and he's going to go here and we're going to draw a purple card. Because there's really not much else we could do. I mean, I could get money and other things, but like I need to know what this is. Oh, a level 8 red wine. That's going to be worth 4 points and that residual payment. And a level 8, that is going to be tough. That's all the way over here. So we've got quite a ways to go. We have to start building these cellars. So maybe I should have taken the money just to build these cellars because I need at least 4 to build a medium cellar. So that's... Ooh. Okay. Let's see here. He could draw another. Well, I could use this and draw another one, but I'm really maxed out on cards. I don't think I should do that. I'm going to stop. So we're going to age the wine and the grapes at the end of the round here. Still can't age these guys because we don't have that medium cellar. Hopefully we'll get one on this next turn. I do have a plan to get that medium cellar. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to retrieve our workers. So I'll take all of my workers back. This yoke, I'm glad I took that. That's been coming in very handy because it keeps getting blocked. We'll take the purple one. Round 3 wasn't as good as round 2 for us. That's okay. We'll move the rooster up so you can see the options. And we are going to collect residual payments. Right now it's just 1. Just 1. And then we are going to discard down to 7 cards. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 cards. We have to... Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards. I'm sorry. So we have to discard 3 cards. Well, first things first, we're going to discard both of these guys because they're just worth 1 and I want to get better stuff. So that's 2. I have to discard 1 more. I'm going to get rid of the stonemason because I need 8 to do it and I don't think I'm going to get there at this moment. So next we move on to the spring phase. So we choose our wake up positions. Now I can draw cards again if I want. I'm going to go here, I'm going to take this, and that's going to let me draw a green card. Hopefully it's something good. And it's another Malvasia. Oh, our luck is not with us in the cards here. The heart of the cards. Come on, guys. You need to treat us well. So that was that, I suppose. Now we need to move on to worker placement, which means we have to draw an automa card. This one, we're not going to be able to plant this turn, which is kind of unfortunate. So that's going to go there. We are not going to be able to... Oh, that's it. We don't worry about because that's the other phase of the game. So that actually wasn't too bad because the only one we want to plant would be this one, and I don't want that card anyway. So that actually worked out kind of okay for us. Now let's determine what I want to do. Well, first things first, I'm going to go here. I'm going to give a tour, and I'm going to use one of my bonus tokens to... So I'm going to get 2 for... going there, and then I'm going to get an additional one because I took the bonus action. So I got 3 total, which is awesome. The next thing I want to do is I'm going to build a structure, and I'm going to spend 4 to build the medium cellar. So now these can age, which is very, very important. Now if I get 6, I can build the large cellar. Now I'm going to, I'm going to go to the yoke and harvest, because I can harvest that, and that's going to add, I'm going to harvest 1 field, so it doesn't matter which one I'm harvesting, they're going to give me the exact same thing, So I'm gonna put that there and that there. So we're really getting up into these. Now the nice thing about the crush pad is there's no limit. Like if this is 3, I don't have to wait and upgrade my crush pad. They will still age to 4. So that's really nice. The only thing is they won't become wine until I have that cellar. Now they can become wine. So that's a big thing. So now I'm going to hold off on these two guys and we're gonna move on to the winter phase. But I need to draw a card first. And I think I'm going to draw a yellow one because I only have the one left. So this one is the contractor. I can choose 2, gain a point, build 1 structure, or plant 1 green card. That's a great card and I really enjoy that card. So we'll definitely do that on our next turn if we can. So next, it is the Autumnus turn. Green, red is Tusking, we don't have to worry about that. Play a blue card. Well, that's not particularly helpful. And fill, which is not good at all. That's not what we wanted. So now we can't, unless we use our Grande worker, we can't fill wine and we can't play a blue card, which are the two ways we'd be able to fill wine right now, unless we use that worker. This is not good. At all. So I think we have to use the Grande worker to do one of those things. What I can do is I can still make wine tokens. So we'll do that. So I'm going to make a wine token and I'll use one of these bonuses to do it just to really get in there. So I'm going to use this 2. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? Yeah, I'm going to take this 2. And that's going to become a level 2 wine. And I can make a second one. I'm going to take this one. And the reason I'm doing that is because there's already 3 here. I'd have to put it below anyway. These will age to 4. So I might as well age them higher if I can. So that's where that'll be. Actually, I'm not going to use this token like I said I was going to because I only have to age 2. These need to age a little more before I can use them properly. What do I want to do with that Grande worker? What do I want to do with the Grande worker? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I already got 9 cards. I have to discount down to 2 anyway. You know, we're just gonna go here and take some money because I really don't see an option here, which is very unfortunate. This is what's so hard about this game, is that Autumn deck, but I love it. So now, all of our workers are out. So now it's gonna be the end of the year. So we have to age all of our grapes. We have our medium cellar. This can go up to 4, which is awesome. This is gonna go up to 3. This will go up to 4, to 2, to 4, and to 2. So this actually is looking very good. We just have to work a little harder. We have to get this upgraded. We can fulfill this on our next turn potentially because we have a 4, we have a 3, we just need a 2. We could fulfill this card right here. So that's really good. So that's what we're gonna try to do. And I did just have to step away from the camera for a little bit. So if I'm screwing up something here, I apologize. But to give you the idea of gameplay, I'm not too worried about it. So now we are going to retrieve all of our workers. So we're gonna get all of our guys. Get the purple guys out of there. There we go. All right, and then next we're going to collect our residual payment. We still only get the 1. Hopefully that will change on our next turn. And then we discard down to 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We gotta get rid of 2 cards. So I think first and foremost, I'm gonna get rid of this card because we don't need this. Again, getting rid of it for the exact same reasons I got rid of it last time. We don't need it. Next, I think I'm gonna get rid of this card right here. And the reason I'm gonna get rid of this card is because it's a level 5. We also have to get a level 4 right here. This is only worth 2 points, that's worth 4. The other one's also worth 4, that's 8 points, that's a lot of points. So we're gonna get rid of this one. That might come back to bite us in the butt later, but you know, for now that's okay. All right, so now we have to figure out what we wanna do for this next one. We only got 3 rounds left and we're really hurting for points. So I think the best thing, the only point we've gotten is the one we took in the first round. That's really bad. So I think what we need to do, we gotta take this extra worker because we've gotta be able to do stuff. So I'm gonna come down here, I'm gonna take this extra worker. So this extra worker, we only get him for this round, but we still get an extra one. So without training, we just get an extra guy, which is awesome. So we're gonna take advantage of that. So now we did that, we are going to draw our Autumn card. We can't draw a green card this turn. So, that's gonna go here. We can't play a yellow card this turn, which, I mean, we probably could have done really something really well with that. We might still take advantage of that. And the other two are red, so we don't have to worry about that. So that just gets discarded. I'm shaking the camera. All right, so now we are gonna move on to the next phase here. So, the first thing I think I wanna do, we have a lot of guys, I'm gonna take this guy right here. And I'm gonna place him here. He can go there because he's the Grande worker. We're gonna play this card. It says choose two, gain a point, build a structure, or plant a card. What we're gonna do, I think, is, you know what, actually no, we're not gonna do that. The first thing we're gonna do, we can't go here anyway, so the first thing we're gonna do, you know what, no, we're just gonna take one of our guys, we're gonna harvest like we have been, because I feel like that's a really good move. So that's gonna go and just give us another one of these, another one of these. Next thing we wanna do is I gotta get some money. I'm gonna take one of my guys, I'm gonna put here. Actually, I'm gonna take the Grande worker and put him there so he can take the bonus action. So he's gonna get three. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my bonus act, my bonus cube there, glass token, to use the additional thing again. I don't know if I'm allowed to do that, but I'm gonna do it anyway and take another one. And just to make it easier for you guys to see, I'm just gonna trade up these two for a one here. Or for, yeah, there we go, these ones for a two. That way you can see what I've got. I've got 2, 4, so I've got 8 things to buy with, which is awesome. Now what we're gonna do is we are going to build a structure, which is awesome. And we're gonna build this one for 6. So 2, 4, 5, and 6. And that's gonna allow us to build our large structure, which we need to fulfill this card right here, because that's a level 8. So now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna save these three guys for the next round, or for the next worker placement phase, because I don't wanna sell yet. I mean, it could give me a point, but I mean, it really just gives me money at this point, and I got money another way. So, and then what we're gonna do is, we can't really plant anything because we don't have any cards. So there's really not much else we can do here. So besides gain a money, but I'm gonna wait and see what happens here. So now we are going to figure out what visitor card we want. I think the best visitor card to grab at this point in the game, I'm gonna scooch these down a little bit, would be a blue one. So it's a scholar. Draw 2 purple cards or pay 3 lira to train 1 worker. You may lose 1 victory point to do both. Well, it's not great, but it does give me 2 purple cards, so it does give me stuff that I can fill. So it's something we could potentially do. So let's move on to this phase. We're gonna grab this. We can't do green. Red is something that we're gonna have to do. Harvest 1 field. That's not good. I mean, it's not, it's probably a better thing that could have happened. And then training, which we weren't gonna do anyway. So that actually works out pretty well. That actually works out pretty well. I'm sorry I keep hitting the camera. So now we gotta figure out what we wanna do. First thing is first. I want to make up to 2 wine tokens. That's just something I need to do. We have a 3 here. That's gonna go to 3. We then have this 5, which we would, if we put a 5 here, we'd have to go down to 3 because there's already a 4. So I feel like the best option here is gonna be this 3, which is fine. I'll take it, and because we can always upgrade later if we have time. I don't know if we'll have enough time to fulfill this 8 one, but that's okay. Next, what we're gonna do is we are gonna fill wine, and we're gonna use this bonus point, or bonus glass token, to use the bonus, which is an extra point. So we're gonna take that extra point, and we are gonna fulfill this right here. So this, we have a level 4, so we have to get rid of this, a level 4. Oh, we don't have a level 2, never mind, we can't. We can't do that, although, actually we can, we just get rid of all 3. So we have level 5, 4, and a 3, we'll just get rid of all of them. So that's how you do it. Unfortunately, you have to lose the wine if you use it. So we're gonna get rid of that, but it gives us 4 points, and it gives us 1 up on the residual. So we just take our little wine bottle, point it to the 2, and we're gonna get rid of these 3 tokens here. And now we're on the board, we have 6 points, which we have a lot to go through, so, but that's really good for us. We still have 1 more worker here. And I think we might wanna we may want to play a blue card. Let's see what we can do here. Well, that would be useful, but I can't really do that right now, but I will on my next turn. I'm going to plan on playing my Zoologist on my next turn, because that'll help us. I'm going to play Scholar. So I'm going to take this extra worker that I got, take him over here, and I'm going to play the Scholar card. I'm going to draw two purple cards. So this one's going to go way over here, and I'm going to get to draw two purple cards. So the first one is, oh, we already have this one fulfilled, so that's really awesome. So we'll be able to fulfill that on our next turn. And the next one is this one. And oh, this is a blush, which we don't have, but we potentially could have it. So that's another 4 points there. So this is really, we're actually in good position to make up some ground here. So that's really, really good. Will I have enough to do that? I would have to, yeah, I think I could do it, potentially. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. I could. We should be able to get both of these, the two cards we just drew, we should be able to get both of those on our next turn. So now let's do the end of year stuff. So we're going to age all of our grapes. This is going to go up to a 6. This is going to go up to a 5. This is going to go up to a 4. That really helps us out. This all gets aged, which is really good. I probably should be selling some of this stuff, and I haven't done it yet, but what are you going to do? We're going to retrieve all our workers. Let's get all these purple guys out of the way. Let's get these back on my board. Okay. Now we only have this worker for this round, only the little gray. He's just going to go out of play because we only had him for the one. So we're just going to get rid of him completely. Move the rooster back up here. And now we're ready for round 6. Round 6 is, things are looking a little interesting for us, but we're going to see what we can do. First thing is, we need to choose our wake-up position. We can either choose a yellow or a blue card or nothing, and I think we have to choose this yellow or blue card, and I feel like we have to choose a blue card. Oh, wait, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We forgot to discard a card. So we're going to go ahead and do that, and I'm going to just discard. I'm going to discard the 8, and the reason for that is I honestly don't think we're going to be able to get it, so we're just going to discard it. We only have 2 rounds left. The highest wine we have right now is a 6. Even if we did get to the 8, it'd be too late, so we're just going to get rid of that card to save some room in our hand. That having been said, we're going to take a blue card, because at this point, playing these cards is going to come into play here. So Mentor, all players may make up to 2 wine, draw 1 green or yellow card for each opponent who does this. Well, that part doesn't apply to us because there's no opponent, but we could still do the first part. All players may make up to 2 wine. So we might do that. We'll see what happens with that. So now we chose our wake-up position. I do get this extra little token here. And now what we are going to do is we are going to draw the Autumn card. So this one says we can't draw a green card, which is kind of unfortunate, but to be fair, it's the last 2 rounds. And we can't give a tour. So that's really unfortunate. So we can't draw a green card, we can't give a tour, so let's get rid of that card. Now we're gonna do some worker placement here. And to be completely honest, I don't know what I wanna do. I'm going to go here to play this yellow card. I'm gonna play the contractor. Choose 2, gain 1 point, build 1 structure, or plant 1 green. Well, I can only do the other 2, so, what do we wanna do? But do we wanna do that first? Yeah, I think we have to. Well, let's sell first, actually. So if we sell first, we could sell one of these, because we're not going to use these. Let's sell this. This is worth 6. This actually, to be fair, the way you sell these is you take a look at the value. This is a max divine value of 6. It's only worth 2. So we're going to take 2, and I think I did that right. It's worth 2, but that's okay, because I'm actually okay with that. So now what happens is this one goes away, because we sold the thing. We sold it, and then this one is going to come up here, and it's going to become sold. So now we can't plant anything there, but I wasn't too worried about it, because we really haven't been making more grapes anyway. So the next thing we're going to do is now we're going to go and play that card. So I'm going to, first and foremost, gain a point. Get that up there. And then the second thing, I'm going to build a structure. Now, it's going to be a matter of what structure do I want to build. That one won't do me any good. The windmill doesn't do me any good. The cottage really doesn't do me any good at this point. The tasting room could. You may just have to do irrigation for 3. Irrigation isn't bad. It does allow us to get some other things if it were to come up and play. You never know. So whatever, we'll just do irrigation. I have to do 2 of the things. So we'll do irrigation, which is here. Okay. Irrigation is just like the trellis. It gives you some of the grape cards require it. So we'll get to that in a minute, if we ever get to. I don't know if we will, but it's something we built. All right, so now, let's see. We can't plant anything. Can't draw a card. Can't give a tour, although we could potentially give a tour because we've got the Grande Meeple. But I want to save him for over there in case something gets blocked. We could build another structure, but I only have one coin to play with, so it's really not worth it. So I think we'll just save everything for that, because that's going to be our best bet, I think, at this late stage in the game. So now we have to pick a visitor card, and I think we're going to pick a yellow one. We have a lot of blue, but the yellow might help us in the next round. Pay $2, or lira, to retrieve up to 2 workers from other actions they may be used again this year. That's going to be awesome. We're definitely going to use that next round. It'll be the final round, and then we basically get 2 free actions for spending. We have to get some money, though. Hopefully we'll get money to do that. Now we're on to the winter action. Let's take a look at the autumn card. Green doesn't apply. Green doesn't apply. Yellow does. Yellow does not. And it's just the training action. So this actually worked out really well for us. It's just the training action to be blocked. So this worked really well. So now what we're going to do is we're going to fill. So we're going to fill this token here, and we're going to spend one of these to do it. So that way we get an extra point. We're now going to fill. Actually, the first thing we're going to do, I lied. We're not going to do that first. We're going to go here first to make up to 2 wine tokens. Because what I want to do is I want to take this 6, even though it's a 6, and I want to put it up here on this 3. Because I need that. What we're going to do is we are going to now take a guy and go here. Now we're going to spend the glass token and take the extra point. Now... Oh, we can make up to 2 wine tokens. So I need to make another one. So we'll make this one as well because might as well at this point. Might as well. So I am going, now that I'm here to fill, I'm going to fill this one right here. And actually I'm going to fill this one because it's worth more. Well, I'm going to fill this one. So this is a level 4. And a level 3 red wine, so those come off the table. And we get, for this one fulfilling it, we get 3 points. So that's gonna be another 3 points. And then we actually will get another residual right there. So that's really awesome. Did I take my residual income last round? I can't remember. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I don't know if I did, and if I didn't, that's okay. But we're gonna get rid of this now, so that's awesome. All right, so now, we still have our Grande worker, and I think we're going to play some cards because we really need to. So now, let's see what we've got for playing cards. This might be good. The judge, draw 2 yellow cards or discard 1 wine value of 4 or more to gain 3 points. And I think we're going to do that. So we're going to send this guy over here. He could do both actions if he wanted to. So we're going to get rid of 1 4 or more. And I'm just going to get rid of this because I don't need it. Necessarily. I need the 5. This is going to become a 6 on the next turn anyway. So we're going to get rid of the 6 that we had, and that'll give us 3 points. So, oh, things are getting tense now. We've got to make up some points. We're really making up points now. So that's going to go there. He could play another one if he wanted to. I don't know if we can. This one is all players may make up to 2 wines. Well, I could do that. Potentially, I should do that, actually. So I'm actually going to play Mentor with him because he can play 2. All players may make up to 2 wines. Well, what we're going to do instead of making 2 wines is we're going to discard both of these, which is a 2 red and a 2 white. We're going to actually make a 4 blush, which we need for that card. So that's going to go here. And we're all set up to get 4 points and almost win the game on our next turn. We just got to make a couple more points, which hopefully we get there. We'll get there. Let's see. So we just need to get some money involved and maybe we can get some points here. We're going to be very close. This is going to be very, very close. So let's reset for the next round because we're out of workers. So let's get the rooster up here. Let's get these purple guys back. Let's get our guys back. And to be honest with you, I probably have screwed up some rules somewhere, and if I have, I apologize. But the goal of these videos is not to be a how-to-play video, it's just to give you an idea of how the game works. So if I've screwed up a couple times, that's why. Okay, so last round of the game, we have to go here. It's the only one left, but we do get this token, and we are going to be using these on this turn, because if we don't use them, we don't get any benefit at the end of the game, so we might as well use them. So let's draw an Autumn card and see what happens. We can't, this round, we will not be able to draw green cards, which is fine, because we won't be able to use it anyway. We won't be able to play yellow cards. Which, that's not great, because we do have the one that we wanted to use, but that's okay. And the other two are Tuscany expansion, so it doesn't matter. So, this really makes things a little difficult. I think what we need to do, is that all I need is four? Is that the cheapest thing to build? It is. So I just need three. This can get me three. Let's take this worker and place him here and use one of our tokens to get three. To get $3, or lira, I keep calling it dollars, it's lira. To get three. Because I really want to use this card on my next turn, which will get me some extra points here. This is already set, so I think we forgot to age our wine at the end of last year, but it's okay. It doesn't make any difference because they're already aged to where I need them, so it really makes zero difference for the gameplay at this point. So if I forgot, I apologize. Now let's go. I want to save the Grande Worker for over there because I know I'm going to need him to play this card. Like, I want to use him on that card if I have to. Do we save everybody for that? We might just need to. Because I could sell. Actually, I could sell this and get more money, but money doesn't do you anything at the end of the game. So I think my best bet, and I'd be able to play this card, but he blocked it. So I think my best bet is just to save everybody for that one, just to be on the safe side. I still got one bonus action to take, so yeah. Let's take a card, and we're going to take a winter one, because at this point in the game, it's the only one we'd be willing to take. So this is guest speaker. All players may pay 1 lira to train 1 worker, gain 1 point for each opponent who does this. Again, it doesn't affect us at all for that part, but we could do the first part. I'm not going to because it doesn't make any sense to. Now we're going to go on to the next part. We have to draw this card. Now this is going to be the make or break card for us. We don't have to worry about yellow. Harvest 1 field. Perfect. And the blue one is Tuscany. Harvest 1 field. This looks really, really great for us. So now, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fill an order. And I'm going to fill this order, and I'm going to spend this token to do it to get an extra point. So I'm going to take this extra point, and I'm going to fill this order right here, this contract. It's 4 red and 4 blush. We have both. Those will come off the table. So we're going to take both of those off the table, and that is going to give us 4 victory points. 1, 2, 3, 4 victory points, and residual. And I think I forgot to take my money again last round, but it doesn't really matter right now. So that's awesome. We now need 2 points to win the game, because you can't tie. You have to actually get past 20. So purple's at 20. We need 2 points. We have to figure out a way to get 2 points for the game, and I think I know how to do it. This right here is going to do it for us. We're going to go and we're going to play a blue card. And that's going to be this card right here. We're going to build 1 structure at its regular cost. Then if you have at least 6 structures, gain 2. I don't know if I have 6 structures. So let's see. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. This counts as a structure. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that will be the 6th. So we will get those points. So we are going to play this card. Build a structure. It has to be at least 4. Cottage is the only one that's worth 4. So let's go ahead and build that cottage. We're going to get rid of all of our money, get rid of this card, and take, how many points is it? 2 points or 3 points? It is 2 points. That's going to do it for us. We have now surpassed 20, and we have officially won the game. So I hope that gave you an idea of how this works. We officially have won the game. We do have more workers to use, but there's really no point because we surpassed 20. They can't gain any more points. So we did win Viticulture. And that's going to do it for this playthrough of Viticulture. If you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and ring the bell to be notified when more videos are uploaded right here on Instant Gameplay. I will be doing a video pretty soon of the next vote that will be available for you guys, so you guys can figure out what game you guys want to play next. As always, comment down below if there's other games that you do want to see, and maybe we'll get to those first. So, my name is Sean, and from Instant Gameplay, thanks for watching.